With much of the action in the Mid-South starting next weekend, here's where everyone stands after the fall. Navy the busiest out of everybody. Those two losses, though, came to none other than Lindenwood and Life. Every single team in the Mid-South so far ranked in the top 25. And now for our expert for everything on the Mid-South, let's go to Gift Egbelu. GiftTime Rugby, of course. Gift, on your roof today. You bring it something new every week.
You know, I felt like this was something that was important. You know, we got an RIP Kobe, Gianna, and the other seven people died in the helicopter crash this weekend, and a major impact for the sports world. So I want to be high and remember that everything is still bright and shiny, and it's still hot with a little bit of cold. And I think that goes perfectly into what we have to talk about today with Davenport and Clemson.
Yeah, that's right. So we're making our way through the Mid-South right now. And last week, we talked a little bit about Life and everything involving them. But this week, we're going to go with Davenport and Clemson. Start with Davenport. What's hot? What's cold about Davenport this year?
Well, Davenport, man, you look at their film. That is a team that you got to give them a lot of credit and a lot of hustle out of them. Two players that I say that they need to look out, people need to look out for, are their two centers, number 12, Brady Ehrlich, and number 13, Josiah Mukeso. Those two guys are absolute monsters on the field. Brad Ehrlich, this guy goes everywhere. I'm talking about you can't find him not in a tackle, not setting up for a ruck, and that's as a center. And then when you give him the ball, the guy crashes through, he's able to find the hole. The other guy, Josiah Mosepu, Mosepeo, he is a speedy center. Now, he doesn't always have the most impact when it comes to defense, but if you see him on offense, you need to watch out because he's going to get you space down the middle. It is a sight to see.
All right, so that's what's hot. Give us the cold side of things. They've got Life coming up on March 14th, so it can't be too cold.
Well, look, you know, Davenport definitely has their work cut out for them. They're not cold like the weather up in Michigan, but they still have some things to work on. A lot of their problems will come from the fact that they come up as a jagged defensive line. Again, we talked about this last week when it came with Navy, but it's even more emphasized with this Davenport team. They let a lot of holes through just because they're so quick to try and shoot up and make the quick tackle. And what it does, teams are able to sneak through, and it's been an impact for whenever they played Navy, and it made an impact when they played Lindenwood. And luckily, when they took a team like Penn State, they were able to close it in, but it's going to be something that's going to be a problem if they don't get that fixed.
All right, let's get to Clemson now, who actually last time we saw them was when they lost to Davenport, 45-29. Now here, as we look to the spring, give us the hot for Clemson.
Look, Clemson, I got to give them credit. That is a team that hustled. They haven't had a great outing against these the teams in there in the Mid-South, but they are not a team that quit. Regardless of what the score is, they seem to come at the same pace each time. And I give credit to their center, one of their centerpieces, that scrum half number 9, Dak Desmond. That guy knows how to make sure he is setting up the forwards in the ruck, setting up the back ready to play, and he does a great job when it comes to the clear out kicks, giving Clemson a lot of space to be able to maneuver and be able to at least control the game a little bit so they can have a little pace for themselves.
So what's the cold? What are some of the challenges they need to overcome? They've got Life, Lindenwood, Arkansas State all here in the spring here, Gift.
You know, Clemson, as I've talked about before, and I'm not going to take it biasly because they're the anti-Tigers to the LSU Tigers, but it's because that they still have technical things to work on. We talk about defense all the time. I think that's another one where they are very iffy with that. But they also need to work. One-on-one tacklings are very, very much in need of work. Obviously, they work at a different level, different program. So where they pull their talent from is different than a Life, Arkansas State, or Lindenwood. But for being at this level, you know, you want them to be a little bit stronger. They want them to be able to put a little more push on their offense. And, you know, against the Texas A&M, they showed some regard, but they need to bring some of that over to the bigger teams, and that means being a lot more disciplined in their attacks, both defensively and offensively.
Yeah, the Texas A&M win, their only win thus far this year, came in their opener. Gift, thank you so much for joining us. Be careful up there, okay?
Look, you know, we live strong, we live loud, and we want to make sure we make the most of it. Stay high, people!
Good night, Gift. Thanks so much, man. For more things like that, and of course, Gift and the rest of the guys, watch This Week in College Rugby every Tuesday right here on 11 Sports and FDF Next all year long.